When the final light is baked, you can move on to setting out the materials. To do this, let's switch to lid mode and look around. The materials almost fit into the result that I got. This is the result, and as you can see, the materials have been transferred well. But they will need to be slightly corrected. Let's start by creating a curtain. Right-click on an empty space, in the Open Materials and Textures window, create a new material. Prefix M tool. We double-click, or with the material selected, enter, the material editor opens. Hold down the S key and click the left mouse button. Node appears, where we write diffuse color in the name. This will be the color of our material. Hold L on the keyboard, left-click, Node Lerp appears. Hold 3, left-click, we have a color. Sign follow color A. Ctrl plus W, copy node and rename it to follow color B. The first node to A, the second to B. Connect everything to opacity. Select the material, blend mode, translucent and tick two-sided. Hold 1 on the keyboard and left-click on an empty space. Connect the appeared node to specular. For convenience, move two slots A and B to the left. Right-click, type Fresnel, enter, and connect Fresnel to the alpha slot in Lerp. Press S on the keyboard and left-click. Write exponent in the node that appears and connect node to the top first cell, Fresnel. Set the default value to 5. Select node, Ctrl plus W, for copying. Put a copy in the second Fresnel slot. And set the default value to 0.004. Rename it to Base Reflect Frag. If two nodes are named the same, then when the value of one of them changes, the copy of the same name will also change. So we go to Exponent in and return 5. Save the material and now create an instance of that material. Right-click on it, create material instance. Select the objects to which we want to assign the material. This will be the tool. You can assign it to the whole tool, you can assign it to the one that will only get into our camera. It doesn't matter basically. Having selected all the objects to which we want to assign a material, the instance that we have just created is transferred to the cell of the selected objects. The cell is called Materials. We need to set up the material. For this, we double-click on it, and in the settings, we just start changing all the counters until we like the result that we see on the tool. You can use approximately my settings, but you can also choose your own settings, because the tool can be of different transparency and you can create the tool that you like best. I made the one that I like, and I will leave such settings. Now let me see how this material looks in the scene. But the background behind the window is not visible. Let's find it. Here's background. Its UVs are expanded. Press Ctrl plus E, go to Mesh Editing. If suddenly you don't find Mesh Editing, then look for Mesh Editing in the plugins and enable plugins that are responsible for editing geometry. Go to Edit Mode, choose where we have Simple. Select an element, select our entire plan, all our geometry and press flip. Do not forget to save. The plan is inverted. Double-click on the slot with the material of the selected object. Select the texture sample at the bottom, click 2 times on the picture, select compression, select default and save. We have an error, so at the bottom we find this picture by clicking the magnifying glass, and by clicking on the arrow again, assign this picture to the texture sample. Our texture was applied normally and now we can make it lighter or darker. To do this, hold down M, left click, the link that goes to the emissive color, connect A, hold down 1 and left click. Connect multiply to emissive. By setting 1, the result will be the same. If we increase the values, we'll make our texture lighter. If we set it less than 1, then the diffuse component becomes darker. In this case, controlled by the emissive color. Let's set up the material of the carpet. To do this, we will select the model itself. And by double-clicking on the cell with the material, we'll open the materials of the carpet. We repeat this procedure. Hold down M, left click, connect the link to A. Hold 1 with the left button, click, connect to B, connect multiply to base color and start changing the value, a lower value to make it darker. To change the color of the material or rather its shade, hold down L on the keyboard, left click, connect multiply to A. Hold down 3, left click, this is the color control. Change the color, for example, to warm, you can choose whatever you want. We connect the color to slot B. LERP itself goes directly to base color. In alpha, we hold down 1 with the left button and click. Load the node parameter, change it, this is the strength of the impact of our color. Let's save, this our warm shade. If we want to reduce it, then we set a correspondingly lower value. If we want to change the shade, we change the color. If we want to change the shade in one direction or another, make it warmer, or make it colder, or even completely change the shade, then we connect the node hue shift. Then we put the texture in LERP and we put the first channel in node and connect the entire chain to base color. Save it and now changing the hue shift parameter. We will change either to this purple or to the opposite shade. If we want to create, for example, instance, then we convert. Right click on node, convert to a parameter. Here it is also convert to parameter with the right button and sign color tint. Here it is the same, with the right button, convert to parameter, we sign what kind of parameter it is, in this case it's hue. And now, having found our material, with the right click on it, create material instance and apply now, this time instance. We double click on it and see, we can change the values and our parameters change in real time. Thus, you can create any parameters and change the required material properties in real time. For example, we made it a little purple as on the reference. We convert the color into a variable parameter and now, simply by signing solve that is clear to us that this is color tint, we can change this parameter in our instance in real time. We put a tick, I set the strength more and now any shade that we would not assign, it will immediately change on the surface. This is very convenient, and instances save memory too. This is a kind of optimization. Thus, we have now slightly edited the material and you can add one more parameter, contrast, for example. We need cheap contrast RGB. We put it in cheap contrast RGB, hold S with the left button, click, we'll have a parameter for instance, connect this whole chain to base color, save it. Now we go to Instance. Here the contrast has already appeared. We activate the contrast and now you see what happens. We just change the value of contrast and see the change on the material, on the object in real time. So we can take any object, go to Materials, to its settings. Let's get back to the carpet. We selected the carpet, clicked on the magnifying glass and found it in Content. Double-clicked, went to Parent, which was initially the main material. See the structure? We can copy. I selected the required nodes, Ctrl plus C, here Ctrl plus V, and here we just copied the albedo component. By albedo I mean doing darker and lighter. Accordingly, by changing this albedo parameter, we make it lighter or darker. Let's move on to the wall. We look at what is the same here, Ctrl plus V, or you can create it yourself, but to save time we use copy-paste. We also connect this whole chain to base color and make it either darker or lighter at your discretion. This should be done basically with any material, making it its desired shade, contrast, making lighter or darker. Let's move on to the leather. Let's do the same here. Ctrl plus V, insert into the first channel. Into A, our chain and the general chain in base color. Save. I'll try to create a simple parameter. Let's see how it affects. Hold down S, left click, called it metallic. Raise the default value a little. Metallicity gives more shine and at the same time the material will become darker for us. Let's move on to the floor. It is too mirrored as it is blend material and consists of two materials and one map. Here's this map. We see virtual texture in lower right corner. What do we need to do? Find this texture by clicking on the magnifying glass in the lower left corner. And having found this material, this texture, right click on it, convert to regular texture and texture size threshold set, for example, 4096. OK. Double-click on one of the blend materials and use the same procedure to insert the multiply into the roughness. Roughness controls glossiness. Accordingly, the more we raise the value, the more matte the material becomes. Here's the result that I made before the start of the course. And now we need to get closer to it. We return to the main material, twice on the second node, and here we repeat the same, roughness, Ctrl plus V, connect to multiply our chain that led to roughness. Sign that this is roughness, so as not to forget the next time we want an instance to create it. It will be already easy to do. We increase the value, you see the table turns out to be not so varnished.